Serge Morand, in 2016, you wrote the book The Next Plague. According to you, was this pandemic expected?
It was clearly expected. So when we look at the data, what is the main driver? The main driver, first, is that you have an increase of the cattle livestock. At the same time, we lose biodiversity. At the same time, we have an increase of the outbreaks. What happened? Still 1960 with the great acceleration was an acceleration of the number of domestic animals, the livestock. Take for example the number of cattle, 1960s 1 billion, now more than 1.5 billion. Actually the total weight of cattle is more than the total weight of humans. At the same time we have the increase of the number of threatened animal species. Same time, we have the increase of the number of air passengers on the air traffic from 500 million in 1970 to more than 2.5 billion of travel passengers in 2018. And in this case, with the global mobility of humans and goods, everything is transported all over the world.
Well, at first glance, the link between health and the environment may seem counterintuitive, since the greater the biodiversity is, the more infectious diseases they are, and yet the fewer epidemics there are. So how can this be explained from a scientific point of view, Serge Morand?
So when we are looking at the number of infectious diseases or parasitic diseases that have been recorded in the country, there is a good correlation with the number of bird and mammal species described in the country. Very paradoxical, which is normal, because parasitic or infectious diseases are microbes or are parasites. And diversity of this is completely linked with the diversity of the wildlife. Actually, when the biodiversity decreases, you lose the very important things. You lose the regulation. You lose the regulation of the reservoir of the virus and bacteria by the predator or by the competitors. You need also all the regulation of the vectors by some other predators. So in this habitat with a reduced biodiversity, you have no more regulation of the transmission of infectious disease.
Today, while there are those who advocate for a reconciliation between man and nature, others seek to protect it from human coexistence and create a refuge for the natural world. Others talk about commercializing ecosystem services between natural and inhabited areas. So how should we change our relationship with nature, in your opinion, Serge Morand?
Yes, you have very well summarized the three potential paths we have to take. And I will start with the first one, which is mentioned like half of the planet. It was Edward Wilson proposing this kind of ideas and working on this. And we save completely half of the planet with the nature and people in this. And the other one is given to all the other humans, and you can do what you want with this. This will never work because the planet and the human on the planet is unique. The second one is the ecosystem services. And actually, we have already discussed about the use of ecosystem services in terms of regulation of infectious disease. The only problem that this is, you have to put some price with the market, is an economical valuation of this, which is very difficult and sometimes a lot of problem and potential problem in terms of the neoliberalisms of the nature. And the last, which I really an advocate for this, is the ecological solidarity. So considering that we have to think in social ecology, so we have to increase the resilience of the territory, so local territory, local landscape, which in this case you will increase the resilience for the ecological resilience. You will increase the solidarity, and actually you will also increase the resilience facing the risk of infectious disease.